If you reach for an energy drink every time you need a boost, you might want to reconsider. Those things are not good for you. Hey guys, Amy with you on DNews today. Energy drinks have become common in the United States in recent years, offering a quick energy boost to match a fast-paced life. And they work because they're packed with sugar, caffeine, and other stimulants, none of which are great for you in large doses. The sugar in energy drinks hits your system first, giving you a spike of energy, then a crash. The crash is offset by caffeine, which stimulates the central nervous system with a bit of a time delay. Peak caffeination hits after about an hour, and the increased energy can last all day as it slowly wears off. It's safe to ingest about 400 milligrams of caffeine per day if you're a healthy adult. For perspective, a 16-ounce grande brewed coffee from Starbucks has 330 milligrams of caffeine, a 16-ounce can of Rockstar has 160 milligrams, and one 8.4-ounce can of Red Bull has 80 milligrams. Consuming caffeine is known to cause heart palpitations, anxiety, and insomnia. It's also a diuretic, causing the kidneys to produce extra fluid into the urine, leaving the body severely dehydrated. It can also become addictive, meaning the body will need more to feel the stimulating effect, and the cycle continues. Where energy drinks are concerned, the effects of caffeine are amplified by stimulants. Ephedrine is a nervous system stimulant often found in these drinks. So is guarana, a South American shrub whose seeds contain more caffeine than a coffee bean. And so is taurine, an amino acid that acts as a neurotransmitter. But in moderation, it's all fine, right? Well, maybe not. A study from the Mayo Clinic says that even one energy drink can cause momentary health changes that could increase the risk of heart conditions over time. The study had adults abstain from caffeine and alcohol before consuming either an energy drink or a placebo. Those who drank the real thing showed a marked increase in caffeine levels, blood pressure, and norepinephrine levels, the sudden spike of which could predispose those people to cardiovascular problems down the line. We're already seeing this happening. ER visits related to high caffeine and taurine levels in energy drinks have doubled in the last decade, particularly in patients between 18 and 25. Another study found a correlation between energy drinks and traumatic brain injuries in young adults. The EU Scientific Committee on Food found that increased caffeine intake brought behavioral changes, including increased arousal, irritability, and nervousness. One woman in the UK actually started losing her sight because of an energy drink habit. The sugar in the drink caused her to gain weight, and at 364 pounds, she developed idiopathic intracranial hypertension. Her optic nerves swelled, leading to temporary blindness. And it gets worse if you mix energy drinks with alcohol, a common practice with devastating consequences that Tara talks about in this video right here.
The rate of emergency room visits involving energy drinks has doubled between 2007 and 2011, prompting the FDA to ban most pre-mixed alcoholic energy drinks. Unfortunately, that ban doesn't extend to bars.
We'll have a link to that video in the description for those of you on mobile. So there are definitely better ways to boost your energy, like eating a healthy diet, exercising regularly, and getting into good sleeping habits. How do you guys get going when you're low on energy? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.